Hi and welcome to my Shadow Stitch Heel tutorial. My name is Caroline and I'm the host of the Ariabart Design podcast and the designer behind Ariabart Designs. I'm here today to provide a visual aid to the heel used in my pattern, Ferret Feet Socks. I chose this heel as it eliminates the gap that would normally form between the heel and the body of the sock. You also don't have the gaps forming in between the stitches that you can sometimes get. On the inside, you do have this line forming. Now, I've never had a problem with how this feels on my feet. My partner does have really sensitive feet, and he's also never had a problem with how this feels. It also looks like a bit of a seam. Now I've got a light here, and I'll try and angle this so you can see there is absolutely, let me move my hand, no gaps at all. Obviously, if this is an issue, then feel free to substitute it with your preferred heel. So now we'll get on to the tutorial on how to produce the shadow stitch heel. What I've done is I've ripped back to the lifeline that I placed when I was originally doing the swatch. So here's the lifeline here running through. In the pattern, you can either follow the written instructions or you'll receive a chart, something similar to this. Obviously, it's got your 28 stitches, which is what's on the needle. Now, this chart doesn't contain the legend for the stitches, but the pattern will have the legend on it. Now what we're going to do once I get organised is, on the chart you've got to knit 27 stitches, then place the shadow stitch at the end. So I'll just get this. So we're going to knit across. So we're one stitch away from the last stitch, so we'll just knit this one. Now what you're wanting to do is, on the life stitch, you're wanting to go into the right leg of the stitch below, place it on the needle. You're wanting to knit this stitch, slip it back onto your left hand needle. Give it a wee tug just to make it secure, and then turn. And then, as per the pattern, you're going to purl back all the way to the last stitch on the wrong side. So that's us to the second last stitch. We'll just purl this stitch. That leaves us with our last stitch. We're going to slip that purl wise onto your right hand needle. You're going to lift the bar that's right underneath, and we're going to purl into that stitch and just snug it up. Turn your work and slip it back. Now what we're going to do is we're going to knit all the way back until we hit the stitch before the last shadow stitch that was made. Reposition the camera slightly so that the knitting's actually in the frame. So we're just going to continue knitting along until we hit the stitch before the last twin stitch that was worked. Now there's the last twin stitch and the one before. As previously, we're going to go out, use this right leg. We're going to lift it up to the left hand needle. We're going to knit through the leg and then transfer it back across. So we're going to turn our work and head back and do the same on the other side. Okay, so we've come to the stitch before our last twin stitch. Just there. We're going to slip that purlwise onto your right needle. You're going to lift the bar that surrounds that, purl into that bar, slip it back onto your left hand needle, and then turn your work. Now you just continue on, you just keep working, knitting across, placing your shadow stitch, purl back, place your shadow stitch, and you keep working like that in between the shadow stitch at each end until the desired number in the pattern. I'll come back once I have an equal amount and we'll show you how to turn it and start working back. Now we've completed the desired number of stitches on either side of the heel. Come back to the pattern. Now we've just completed here. So what we're going to do now is we're now going to start taking these stitches back off. So we eventually end up coming back. So what you do is you knit across to the first stitch. The first shadow stitch. Last stitch. Come to the first shadow stitch, we're just going to knit those two together like that. Now in the next stitch we're going to lift this leg up, knit into that stitch, place it back on the left hand needle, so you now have one, two, stitches. So you've knit two together and made your triple stitch We're now going to turn the work and purl back. So that was our last stitch. We're going to purl these two strands together. Now working on the next stitch, we're going to increase that by lifting the leg up, purling into that stitch and transferring those three strands onto your left hand needle. And again, we're just going to work back, knitting the three strands together, creating a triple stitch in the next stitch, purling back along, purl those stitches together, increase to a triple stitch, knit back, knitting those three stitches together and increasing, and you'll just keep doing that all the way up. And we'll come back once we've completed both our last triple stitch on either side of the heel. And we're back. We've now completed increasing back out, completing the heel. Now what we're left with is one triple stitch at the very end of the sock, and we'll have completed the purl triple stitch, which is currently sitting on the right hand needle. If you're doing a contrast heel, what I would suggest you do when you come to this stitch, as I've done here, actually what we'll do is I'll take this off the blocker. So when I was completing the sock, obviously I'd come, worked back across, decreasing it off. When I came across here, obviously the working yarn for the ultramarine is sitting here. So rather than completing the stitch in the Fantastic Adventure, picked up the working yarn for the main colour of the sock and continued, made the triple stitch. Continued working back along, and at this point, going back to the example, you would work back along these stitches, knit these three strands together, continue back round the pattern on the instep of the sock, and then when you get back round to the triple stitch that's left, you would then knit those three strands together and just continue working up the leg of your sock. Now, because this has the texture pattern, what I like to do is after I've done a short row heel is I like to leave about an inch, about half an inch to an inch after I've completed the heel before I continue on working any pattern up the back of the leg. Obviously this is entirely up to you, but I feel it does help with how the sock fits on the back of your leg. So that is how you complete the shadow stitch heel. If you do have any questions, feel free to leave a message down below, or alternatively post a question. Leave your question in the Ferret Feet Socks thread on the Aria Bark Design podcast group. Thank you for watching. Bye!